Hello everyone, my name is Wenbin. I'm a PhD candidate at the Institute of Computing Technology, Chinese Academy of Sciences. This presentation introduces our recent work, FingFormer, Contrastive Graph-Based Finger Operation Transformer for Unsupervised Mobile Game Board Detection. First, I'd like to talk about the background of this paper. Recent years have witnessed a repeated development of mobile terminal devices and the consequent emergence of lots of popular mobile games, such as Genshin Impact, PUBG Mobile. The global mobile game market has grown rapidly over the past few years, and it now worth more than $19 billion, accounting for half of the global game market. However, with the popularity of mobile games, there is an explosive growth of mobile game boards. They pretend to be players playing games and react with incredible speed, so as to obtain an unfair advantage against other players. These game boards bring frustrating experience to the honest players, resulting in the loss of players and the consequent economic losses to the game companies. Therefore, in order to distinguish between game boards from honest human players, an effective game board detection method is urgent and critical. For mobile game board detection, only screen sensor data is always available due to two reasons. The first is about generality. Different from some game-related data, screen sensor data is applicable to most mobile games. The second is about privacy protection. Game board detection based only on sensor data does not require access to other private data and is low-level privacy sensitive. However, existing game board detection methods most focus on PC games and are always not applicable to mobile games due to the limited available data. Only few studies detect specific types of mobile game boards, such as autoclicker, based on simple features extracted from the screen sensor data. So far, board detection in mobile games has not been well explored. There are three key challenges for this task. First, mobile games require both hands to work together to complete actions, so the temporal and spatial associations between operations of both hands should be considered. Second, since the cheating samples only account for a very small part of the massive daily data, it is impractical to obtain adequate and comprehensive cheating samples through manual labeling. Third, a game company always operates many games, and each game may have multiple scenes or modes. Thus, we prefer the mode to be generic for different games or different scenes. Before introducing our method, we first explain some definitions. A finger event in screen sensor data denotes a process from a single finger from pressing the screen to leaving the screen. It consists of a point sequence P and the event type gamma. Each point PI in P is a triplet of the X coordinate, Y coordinate, and the time stamp. Gamma denotes current event type, such as click. A record is the event sequence generated by the user U in a given time window. We aim to learn distinctive representations for records in an unsupervised way to distinguish between cheating samples and normal samples. We propose a transformer-style model of FingFormer, which takes finger operations and input in the form of graph structure to incorporate the spatial and temporal relatedness between both hands operations. The underlying basic idea of our model is that operations of different hands are highly related in time. For instance, to approach and attack enemies, players always control the direction of the movement with their left hand and click the attack button with their right hand at the same time. Operations of the same hand are highly related in space, since most operations of the same hand gather in same areas on one side of the screen. The first step is graph building. We have to divide each record into two parts corresponding to each hand. Since all points of an event should belong to the same hand, We simply regard an event belongs to left or right hand when its first point is in the left half or right half of the screen. Then we build a finger operation graph for each record. Take the left part of this graph as an example. Notes in the left part denotes points belongs to the left hand. The attributes of each node vi include the index I, which denotes the node vi is the ith point in all left hand points according to the timestamp. Gamma I, which denotes the event type, dii plus 1, which denotes the coordinate distance to the next point vi plus 1, and alpha I, which denotes the include angle between edges vi minus 1, vi, and vi, vi plus 1. There are two types of edges. Points associated with an intra-edge belong to the same hand, and the points associated with an inter-edge belong to different hands. The attribute of intra-edge is the coordinate distance of its endpoints to model spatial relatedness of each hand. The attribute of inter-edge is the time interval between its endpoints to model temporal relatedness of different hands. Our model consists of two modules. The graph-based encoding module models the operations of each hand and learns the embedding. It consists of two blocks, and each block takes the nodes of each hand as input. The left-right interaction module integrates both left hand and right hand embeddings and studies their interactions. In the graph-based encoding module, we add the attribute of intra-edge to the weight metric of each multi-head self-attention to encode the spatial relatedness. In the left-right interaction module, we add the attribute of the inter-edge to the weight metric of each multi-head attention can encode the temporal relatedness. To optimize our model in an unsupervised way, we introduce two contrastive strategies. The finger movement learning aims to learn the finger moving patterns. The positive sample is generated by downsampling the original record, and the negative sample is generated by randomly sampling another record. The operation habit learning aims to learn players' operation habits. The positive sample is generated by randomly sampling a record of the player who generated the original record, and the negative sample is generated by randomly sampling another record. We conduct experiments on three test datasets to validate the effectiveness and the generality of our model. We randomly sample 100,000 records from scene A in gain zero as train dataset. The offline test data consists of two parts corresponding to two scenes A and B from the same gain zero, each will require amounts of normal and cheating samples. The synthetic test data consists of four types of cheating samples and some normal samples from scene A in gain zero. The online test data consists of a small daily data flow from other three gains. We compiled our model with several trajectory representation learning methods and transformer. For trajectory representation learning methods, we train two submodels for each method, and each submodel learns the embedding of one hand, which are then concatenated as the final representation of the input record. For transformer, we concatenate left-hand sequence and right-hand sequence separated by SIP as input. We apply clustering on embeddings learned by these models and use ARI, NMI, F1 as metric in offline experiment, synthetic experiment, and precision in online experiment. As the results show, our model stands out in synthetic environment, and the visualization of the learned embeddings proves that our model can not only distinguish between normal and cheating samples, but also distinguish between different types of cheating samples. In the offline evaluation, our model also performs much better than other methods. The results of SIMB show that our model is generic two different things of the same game. In the online evaluation, we compare our model with the best performing baseline, T2 vector. When applied to different games, our model achieves much better performance than T2 vector, and the confined cheating samples found a massive Deng data flow. In conclusion, we propose FingFormer, which is the first work to study mobile game bot detection based on the sensor data and pre-training. We introduce a novel graph-based transformer model to study the complex double-hands operation embeddings. We propose two contrastive learning strategies to learn distinctive embeddings for the successful inference of bots. The experiments prove that FingFormer is effective and generic. That's all. Thanks for your watch.
Thank you for the presentation or the video. Wenbin, are you going to be taking questions? Wenbin? I think you're muted if you're saying anything.
Hello everyone. I'm glad to share my work with you. And do anyone have any questions?
Yeah, we have time for some questions if anybody has any. You can also put them in the chat. I have several questions actually, and very interesting work and presentation. I had a question about, you said that your technique were able to look at, to also analyze different types of bots. So I was wondering what kind of bot behaviors were you detecting in terms of like the clustering that you were showing?
Do you mean different kind do you mean that you want to know the features of different kind of game bots?
Yes. That you were able to detect.
We plot all these records and we ask for experts to analyze and then we find that there are several classical types of game bots and since they are very similar and so we sample from the classical types. This is done by manual labeling.
I see. Did you have that in the paper or in other papers? I would be interested to just know what the feature is, like what how the experts have actually manually labeled these different bots. You don't have to answer that now, but if you have that information, it would be really cool to see.
The data set and the features of the data set, number of players every day are asked by the game company, the EasyNet, EasyNet games, to be animals, so we don't give a detailed description about the dataset.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you so much. Thanks for.